Volunteers at Gallier Hall, we're seeing.
I do feel like, though, I'm privy to this big secret.
It is.
When I find out just a few hours before everybody else does.
And you better not tell anybody, pal.
Oh, I don't. It's locked down. I'm a vault. It doesn't get out.
Yeah, you didn't even share it with me, Scott.
I know. I know what Arthur will do if any of that.
This is important stuff. Let me tell you.
This is. Look at Gallier Hall virtually empty over there.
Yeah, it's a shame.
I'll come back out. Our first group is
Ross Volunteers of Texas A&M.
Two units back.
Yep, been leading the parade for years.
Of course, at WDSU, we have crews all over the area covering Carnival from just about every single angle. From Metairie to Bourbon Street to Lee Circle to here atop the Hotel Intercontinental. It's been a fabulous day so far. Everybody in really good spirits and smiles all around.
Rex's theme this year is Gods of All Ages, and each float this year has a different doubloon that they're throwing that is specific to that float. And you can actually collect an entire parade's worth of beads.
Yeah, beads.
Did I say doubloons?
Yeah, you did.
I'm sorry,
beads.
Have their own unique beads that they'll float that are unique to each float. So you can get all these different beads that relate to each float.
That's a tough set.
And that's the first time they've done this, right?
I think they did it last year.
Specific,
but it's really a tough set to get. And now many of their other items are saluting the Streetcar Named Desire float. They've got bracelets and cups and other beads, but the float-specific beads are the most collectible because you've got to get one from each float. And how do you do that?
Tough stuff. And, of course, the Butterfly King is the most recent new addition float-wise to the Rex Parade, which, is incredible. And these themes, they put a lot of time and effort into picking these themes every year. And really, it's not just like somebody, they get together at lunch one day and come up with a theme.
Oh, no.
There's a whole lot of thought and effort that goes into this.
And they have themes picked for the next 2 years. And probably most of next year's parade finish in the design stage.
I can see Rex coming now.
I can, too.
Looks like he's just about there at Gallier Hall.
Yes.
Making the approach slowly but surely. You know, it's interesting, Arthur, we talked about Zulu and all the charity work and things that they do in the community that might not be talked about so much. You know, you've got coconuts, but you also have a lot of charity work. What about Rex?
Oh, Rex, too. They've given away several $1 million since, raised and given away since Katrina, Pro Bono Publico Foundation, primarily to help public schools and charter schools. And I've seen firsthand the benefits of those programs at my school, my alma mater, Warren Easton High School. I'm on the board of directors of the charter school. We've received over $40,000 from them in the last 4 years and used that money to help the children beef up their ACT scores, which gets them into better colleges, gets them scholarships. So this is boots on the ground kind of work. It really has done some good to so many schools, and they should be applauded for that.
Year-round. That's a year-round
Year-round, absolutely.
And I don't think we can talk about this philanthropy enough that these crews do, because that's often overshadowed by, obviously, the parade, which is the big event. But Rex and Zulu put so much back into the community and give so much time and effort outside of the parade throughout the year.
Yeah, and not just them. Many crews do. And you must remember, that's not the purpose of a Mardi Gras organization. It's to have fun, spread joy, have a parade and ball. It's got nothing to do with anything but that. And yet, they do more than that, and they're to be congratulated.
That's evolved over time. It didn't begin that way originally.
No, it did not. But it has evolved, and a lot of crews step up to the plate. Some make a big deal out of it, and others don't. I think it's good to promote it because people need to know this. And the other thing is, people will donate if they find out, hey, if you're doing that, well, maybe I can chip in a couple hundred bucks and see how it goes.